we're going to practice a technique called refiling. As we progress, let my voice provide the energy and direction for you. Let me guide you through each step. When you're ready, make sure you are in a comfortable position and just close your eyes and relax. Take a few breaths to settle your mind. Let all tension and worry disappear. Relax. Just relax. Relax. All right, let's begin. I want you to recall whatever the situation is where you had a difficult time. The first step is to be honest about what is really happening in the scene. Ask yourself what is actually going on in the environment during the experience. As you replay the experience in your mind's eye, remove any opinion or interpretation about what is happening and be coldly descriptive, using only first-order data. Imagine someone disconnected from the situation took a video of it, and you're watching it through their eyes. Play the experience back just as the video would capture it. Try to avoid bringing up any stories or background that you have connected to the scene, or making any judgments about what emotions or memories are present. For now, just focus on the facts of the events that are unfolding. Now that the memory is fresh in your mind, you are ready for the next step. As you replay the memory, ask yourself what feelings are present in you as the event unfolds. Be careful not to get lost in the feelings, and don't bring in any stories or history other than what a camera would record. So bring back up the memory of the situation and be honest about what feelings are present. Now, I want you to try to separate the emotion from the feelings. We want to get to the emotion because that will tell us what your Annabelle, your emotional or subconscious self, was trying to do. Once you have in your mind which of the three emotions is dominant, honestly articulate to yourself what, in the moment of the situation, is your interpretation or evaluation of what is going on. Until this interpretation overlay has been exposed, you can't move on to the next step. When you have those three elements in mind, the first order data, the emotion, and the story, you are ready to replay the scene again from the beginning in your mind's eye. But this time, as you do so, I want you to point out the parts of the memory picture that show your Annabelle that the emotion that is coming up is not the right one for the situation. You need to communicate with her at a level a child would understand, so use pictures as much as possible or very simple language. You're now ready for the last step. Look at what the human bodies are doing in your memory of the situation, and with the benefit of distance, ask yourself, what is the appropriate response? What are the best possible actions for those bodies? What are the best possible feelings in that situation? Then imagine the situation happening again from the beginning, but this time, as it unfolds, I want you to change the image. I want you to modify the memory and watch yourself give the appropriate response. Now replay it again, but imagine yourself reacting with just the right feelings, perfectly appropriate to the situation. Now, one more time. Play the memory through again with the reactions, the thoughts, the feelings, the actions that best fit the situation. And you're done. Give Annabelle a big hug and tell her what a good job she's done in this practice. Well done.